A wide area network (WAN) is a telecommunications network or computer network that extends over a large geographical distance, place. Wide area networks are often established with leased telecommunications circuits. Business, education and government entities use wide area networks to relay data to staff, students, clients, buyers, and suppliers from various locations across the world. In essence, this mode of telecommunication allows a business to effectively carry out its daily function regardless of location. The Internet may be considered a WAN. Related terms for other types of networks are personal area networks (PANs), local area networks (LANs), campus area networks (CANs), or metropolitan area networks (MANs), which are usually limited to a room, building, campus or specific metropolitan area respectively. Design options. The textbook definition of a WAN is a computer network spanning regions, countries, or even the world. However, in terms of the application of computer networking protocols and concepts, it may be best to view WANs as computer networking technologies used to transmit data over long distances, and between different LANs, MANs and other localized computer networking architectures. This distinction stems from the fact that common LAN technologies operating at lower layers of the OSI model, such as the forms of Ethernet or Wi-Fi, are often designed for physically proximal networks, and thus cannot transmit data over tens, hundreds, or even thousands of miles or kilometers. WANs do not just necessarily connect physically disparate LANs. A CAN, for example, may have a localized backbone of a WAN technology, which connects different LANs within a campus. This could be to facilitate higher bandwidth applications or provide better functionality for users in the CAN. WANs are used to connect LANs and other types of networks together so that users and computers in one location can communicate with users and computers in other locations. Many WANs are built for one particular organization and are private. Others, built by Internet service providers, provide connections from an organization's LAN to the Internet. WANs are often built using leased lines. At each end of the leased line, a router connects the LAN on one side with a second router within the LAN on the other. Leased lines can be very expensive. Instead of using leased lines, WANs can also be built using less costly circuit switching or packet switching methods. Network protocols including TCP, IP deliver transport and addressing functions. Protocols including packet over SONET, SDH, multiprotocol label switching (MPLS), asynchronous transfer mode (ATM), and frame relay are often used by service providers to deliver the links that are used in WANs. BI.25 was an important early WAN protocol, and is often considered to be the grandfather of frame relay, as many of the underlying protocols and functions of BI.25 are still in use today. With upgrades by frame relay, academic research into wide area networks can be broken down into three areas: mathematical models, network emulation, and network simulation. Performance improvements are sometimes delivered via wide area file services or WAN optimization. Topic: connection technology. Many technologies are available for wide area network links. Examples include circuit switched telephone lines, radio wave transmission, and optical fiber. New developments in technologies have successively increased transmission rates. In CA 1960, a 110-bit bits per second line was normal on the edge of the WAN, while core links of 56 kilobits per second to 64 kilobits per second were considered fast. As of 2014, households are connected to the Internet with dial-up, ADSL, cable, WiMAX, 4G or fiber. the speeds that people can currently use range from 28.8 kilobits per second through a 28K modem over a telephone connection to speeds as high as 100 gigabits per second over an Ethernet 100G BASE connection. The following communication and networking technologies have been used to implement WANs. 400 Gigabit Ethernet. AT&T conducted trials in 2017 for businesses to use 400 Gigabit Ethernet. Researchers Robert Maher, Alex Alvarado, Domanic Lavery, and Polina Bavel of University College London were able to increase networking speeds to 1.125 terabits per second. Christos Santis, graduate student Scott Steger, Amnon Yariv, Martin and Eileen Summerfield developed a new laser that quadruples transfer speeds over fiber optic cabling. If these two technologies were combined, then a transfer speed of up to 4.5 terabits per second could potentially be achieved, although it is unlikely that this will be commercially implemented in the near future. See also.